What do you want? Leave us alone.
Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's the Artcast. What do you guys think of the intro? Pretty cool, huh? Let's go. All right, man. I'm working on, I'm actually working on part of the intro. I had this footage left over, so.
A little warning to all the nice people that follow me and watch me on YouTube. Don't like the drama. Just fair warning, I'm probably going to start up some drama on the show, so maybe you want to, you know, duck and cover your privates, whatever you want to do. But yeah, I'm probably going to start some drama up right here. Today, I guess, I was over watching Edwin Boyette's channel, and I don't know if you guys remember him, but when my Indiegogo was running, and I wasn't getting much traction, you know, for the Berserkonaut, of course. He let me come on his show. This was right after I interviewed Doug Tenapel, and Doug Tenapel kind of gave me a little bit of a bump. You know, having him on the show, I think, kind of got some people's attention outside my audience. And then I went on to Edwin Boyette's show, which at the time he was hardcore Comics Gate kind of deal, and he even gave me sort of a warning before we went live that, you know, I could be opening a can of worms by coming on his show. But anyway, I went on, and it was like a really good conversation. He interviewed me, and some people came and pledged, and it kind of amped up my campaign in the middle when it needed it. And then it went on to fund. And so I was really thankful to Edwin for helping me out when I needed it. And I feel like, you know, me and him are kind of friends, even though we don't talk too much. But I like the guy. I like the guy's shows. And I was over there watching some of his videos. And just looking in the chat, I noticed some comments that kind of, you know, insinuated that somehow he steered into the wrong direction of Comics Gate. And so, like, Comics Gate tide has turned once again. And now they don't like Edwin, you know. So, you know, after seeing this, I went over to old Ethan Van Sciver's channel, where all this shit originates. And, he's got a video up. He's got a couple videos up about Edwin. The first one, I guess, I'm not quite sure what Edwin did to get on his bad side, but it's one of those deals where I hate these videos too. It's like one of those kind of response videos where a guy will play your video and then he'll sit there and like stop it every now and then, and, you know, make all kinds of snide comments and stuff like that, you know. And so that's what old Ethan Van Sciver is doing to Edwin, you know, all sorts of little smart ass comments and snide comments and calling him a liar and shit like that. So then after that, I guess, Edwin didn't appreciate that as most people want it, you know, as I want it. I don't think anybody would like that shit. Nobody likes to be hauled up on the fucking, you know, cross and fucking whipped for 40 minutes while everybody laughs at you, right? And so Edwin copyright strikes the video. He's like, hey, that's my content, you know, take it the fuck down, right? And so Ethan figures this out. Figures out who copyright striked him. So he makes another fucking video. And he calls him a liar. He's lied to me 3 times. You know, all this fucking bullshit. And he basically does it again. Fucking, you know, gets him up there for fucking 2 hours. He's bitching and moaning in this live stream about Edwin. And I just don't get it, man. It's like, I mean, why does this fucking dude get to, like, go around and insult everybody and get away with it? And then we all sort of just like duck our heads in the sand and act like it's not happening, you know? Edwin's a nice guy, man. He doesn't fucking deserve this shit. This is already reminding me of when I defended Holly Brown for Tracy. I can feel the trolls coming. But that's the thing, you know, is like, you know, Ethan Van Sciver, huge fucking channel, 100,000 subscribers, whole bunch of fucking anonymous little minions, little trolls that'll all go over and jump all over fucking Edwin's channel for the next fucking month and make his life miserable. You know, just like what happened to Holly. With Holly, it didn't come from Ethan Van Sciver. That was a different situation. But basically, she got trolled to the point where she wanted to leave YouTube, you know. And the thing about it is, like, it'll all originate on Ethan's channel. And then he'll put his hands up and go, like, what? It wasn't me. I can't control these people. I can't control what happens on YouTube, you know. I can't control what they're going to do. And you'll act, you know, like the innocent victim of all this. Everybody blames me. Everybody blames me for being a bully. I'm not a bully. You know. Even though he makes like 2+ hour videos about Edwin. I'm not a bully. I'm not a bully. But I mean, it's like every time I go over there, it's just like some shit's going on like this, you know. Like with Mindy Wheeler, you know. I got all in trouble for the Mindy Wheeler video. Jeff, you don't know what you're talking about. That's what they were saying in the comments. So what? I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm shooting my fucking mouth off again. Yeah. Come tell me I don't know what I'm talking about again. Big fucking deal. I got a YouTube channel. I'm making fucking videos. Try and fucking stop me. There was another guy a while ago. What was that guy's name? Let me go look. Oh, Pocket Jacks Comics was this dude. That was his name. And I knew him because I was on, I don't know, I went and live stream on some show where we all did this drawing thing. That was probably the worst description ever. But basically they gave us like a topic and then in 2 hours we all drew and the chat voted for who was the best. And this guy was on there. And I can't remember what his real name was, but his channel's called Pocket Jacks. Or about Pocket Jacks Comics, and I think he's got a comic actually, and so I mean, like, Ethan fucking makes this. I mean, it was just like the cringiest video. Basically, the same thing. Another response video, you know, where like Ethan gets this guy's video up there and steals it, and then fucking makes all kinds of derogatory comments, and then plays it, and then, you know, it's like, I hate videos like that. I mean, they're so lame because it's like a guy can't even respond. It's like a one-sided argument, you know? You're just throwing insults at a guy and he has no chance to even fucking come back at you. You know, it was like another fucking like hour and a half show where Ethan just fucking, you know, just fucking smears this guy across the pavement. And I remember this one part, it was just so like, just, oh man, I don't know. I hate the word cringy, but it was beyond cringy, where, you know, like Ethan stops the video where the guy looks funny, you know, he's got his mouth open or something, and and then Ethan like turns the camera around on himself and he starts to like mimic him, you know. He's like, oh, he's mad at me, look at him, he's so mad at me, you know. And I couldn't fucking believe, you know, like a guy, like an adult guy, you know, is like doing this. And, you know, he's just fucking just mimicking him with his ugly fat face, you know. I mean, Ethan, you know, he's got those fat fucking pork chop cheeks and that gross beard thing on his face, and I was just like, man, just so insulting, you know, so insulting. And he just laughs and goes on, you know, this doesn't matter to him, you know. And I remember too, he was like saying, it always comes back to like this with him, he's like, oh, he's mad at me because of the money, you know, it's because I make all the money, nobody else makes the money. Or no, not mad, jealous because he makes a lot of money, and like, oh, none of us make money, so, you know, he's making all the money. it's just so lame, man. Actually, he was mad at you because you made a fool of him on the internet. Just like Edwin was fucking mad at you. So mad to the point that he's going to copyright strike you, you know, which is something that could, like, take your fucking channel down. That's why they're mad at you. It's like they're mad at you because you're a fucking jerk on the internet. And you make it your business being a jerk, you know. Your business model is to go out and fight with people and to stir up this fucking drama and then bring it back to your channel and then ride it and then hopefully go find somebody else. But you don't pick on anybody your own size, man. It's like you're 100 fucking plus subscriber channel and you go around and you pick on these guys that, you know, like Edwin's got, what, 2,000 maybe? I don't even know. That Pocket Jacks guy, I don't know. Mindy Wheeler, I mean, what did she have? I have no clue, but I doubt it was over 1,000 subs, really. I mean, you're just a fucking dickhead that just fucking preys on the weak, you know? So I'm sure that'll get me some hate, but I'm just, like, so tired of it, man. I'm so fucking tired of it, and I think there's, like, a whole bunch of people that feel the same way. They just kind of keep their mouth shut for two reasons. One is, like, they don't want to fucking get trolled, which I don't want to get trolled either. I get totally sick of that shit. But I'm fucking tired of it, and I like Edwin. And the second reason is I just think people, they don't want to jeopardize their Indiegogos, their comics. They're like, oh, I don't want to get on the wrong side of this guy. He's like a big fish and shit. But, you know, sometimes you got to speak up. So, all right, I'll see you guys later.